MindCypress, education beyond boundaries.
The seven basic quality control tools, often referred to as the 7 QC tools, are a set of fundamental techniques used for quality improvement and problem solving in various industries. They were first conceptualized in 1950s by Dr. Kaoru Ishikawa, a Japanese quality control expert, to help workers of various technical backgrounds implement effective quality control measures. Here are the 7 basic QC tools: Stratification, Histogram, Check Sheet, Fishbone Diagrams, Pareto Diagrams, Scatter Plot, Control Charts. These tools deal with facts or data, not opinions. 95% of the problems can be solved with the use of these tools. Let's look each of them one by one. Stratification. Stratification analysis is a quality assurance tool used to sort data, objects, and people into separate and distinct groups. Separating your data using stratification can help you determine its meaning, revealing patterns that might not otherwise be visible when it's been lumped together. Whether you're looking at equipment, products, shifts, materials, or even days of the week, stratification analysis lets you make sense of your data before, during, and after its collection. To get the most out of the stratification process, consider which information about your data's sources may affect the end results of your data analysis. Make sure to set up your data collection so that that information is included. Second is histogram. Quality professionals are often tasked with analyzing and interpreting the behavior of different groups of data in an effort to manage quality. This is where quality control tools like the histogram come into play. The histogram represents frequency distribution of data clearly and concisely amongst different groups of a sample, allowing you to quickly and easily identify areas of improvement within your processes. With a structure similar to a bar graph, each bar within a histogram represents a group, while the height of the bar represents the frequency of data within that group. Histograms are particularly helpful when breaking down the frequency of your data into categories such as age, days of the week, physical measurements, or any other category that can be listed in chronological or numerical order. Third is check sheet, or tally sheet. Check sheets can be used to collect quantitative or qualitative data. When used to collect quantitative data, they can be called a tally sheet. A check sheet collects data in the form of check or tally marks that indicate how many times a particular value has occurred, allowing you to quickly zero in on defects or errors within your process or product, defect patterns, and even causes of specific defects. With its simple setup and easy-to-read graphics, check sheets make it easy to record preliminary frequency distribution data when measuring out processes. This particular graphic can be used as a preliminary data collection tool when creating histograms, bar graphs, and other quality tools. Fourth is cause and effect diagram, also known as a fishbone or Ishikawa diagram. Introduced by Kaoru Ishikawa, the fishbone diagram helps users identify the various factors or causes, leading to an effect usually depicted as a problem to be solved. Named for its resemblance to a fishbone, this quality management tool works by defining a quality-related problem on the right-hand side of the diagram, with individual root causes and sub-causes branching off to its left. A fishbone diagram's causes and sub-causes are usually grouped into 6 main groups, including measurements, materials, personnel, environment, methods, and machines. These categories can help you identify the probable source of your problem while keeping your diagram structured and orderly. Fifth is Pareto Chart, 80-20 rule. As a quality control tool, the Pareto chart operates according to the 80-20 rule. This rule assumes that in any process, 80% of a process's or system's problems are caused by 20% of major factors, often referred to as the vital few. The remaining 20% of problems are caused by 80% of minor factors. A combination of a bar and line graph, the Pareto chart depicts individual values in descending order using bars, while the cumulative total is represented by the line. The goal of the Pareto chart is to highlight the relative importance of a variety of parameters, allowing you to identify and focus your efforts on the factors with the biggest impact on a specific part of a process or system. 6 is scatter diagram. Out of the 7 quality tools, the scatter diagram is most useful in depicting the relationship between 2 variables, which is ideal for quality assurance professionals trying to identify cause and effect relationships. With dependent values on the diagram's y-axis and independent values on the x-axis, each dot represents a common intersection point. When joined, these dots can highlight the relationship between the 2 variables. The stronger the correlation in your diagram, the stronger the relationship between variables. Scatter diagrams can prove useful as a quality control tool when used to define relationships between quality defects and possible causes, such as environment, activity, personnel, and other variables. Once the relationship between a particular defect and its cause has been established, you can implement focused solutions with better outcomes. 7th is control chart, also called a Schuhart chart. Named after Walter A. Schuhart, this quality improvement tool can help quality assurance professionals determine whether or not a process is stable and predictable, making it easy for you to identify factors that might lead to variations or defects. Control charts use a central line to depict an average or mean, as well as an upper and lower line to depict upper and lower control limits based on historical data. By comparing historical data to data collected from your current process, you can determine whether your current process is controlled or affected by specific variations. Using a control chart can save your organization time and money by predicting process performance, particularly in terms of what your customer or organization expects in your final product. In summary, the 7 basic QC tools represent a formidable arsenal for organizations seeking to achieve excellence in quality management and continuous improvement. These tools offer a structured and systematic approach to identifying, analyzing, and resolving issues that impact product quality, process efficiency, and overall performance. By mastering these tools and embedding them into your organization's DNA, you not only equip yourself with the means to address immediate challenges, but also cultivate a culture of continuous learning and enhancement. In the ever-evolving landscape of global competition, adaptability and efficiency are paramount. The 7 basic QC tools provide a time-tested framework for enhancing decision-making, reducing errors, and optimizing processes across various industries. Whether you're in manufacturing, healthcare, finance, or any other sector, these tools serve as reliable companions on the journey toward operational excellence. Embracing the power of these tools is more than a choice, it's a strategic imperative. It's a commitment to delivering superior products and services, exceeding customer expectations, and staying ahead in a dynamic market. It's about nurturing a workforce that not only identifies problems, but also actively engages in problem solving, contributing to a culture of innovation and growth. So, as you embark on your quality improvement journey, remember that the 7 basic QC tools are not mere tools but catalysts for transformation. They enable you to see the invisible, solve the unsolvable, and achieve the seemingly unattainable. The pursuit of quality is a never-ending endeavor, and these tools are your steadfast companions on the path to sustainable success. Embrace them. Refine your processes, and watch your organization thrive in the relentless pursuit of excellence.